Valentine hangover. But the reason we're feeling very romantic tonight, in fact, there are two reasons why we're feeling very romantic tonight, is that our special guests tonight are two of the most romantic personalities in showbiz, not only on screen, but also in their real lives. Miss Sharon Cuneta, Mr. Richard Gomez. What a...
Hello.
Hi, Miss Julie.
Hi, Miss Julie.
How nice to have you here.
It's so wonderful to be here finally, because I watch you all the time. So
for,
I'm so glad.
For me also, because I wish you could take over the show.
Oh, no, no,
the
no, no.
You could just sing to me. I'll sit there in one corner and let you work.
Sing, okay, but talk, no. I will never go up against you.
Now, I understand you have prepared a little surprise for our viewers tonight.
I see many, many.
Many surprises. Yes. Oh.
Lalo na ako. Ako nga na surprise eh. Why I'm doing this eh.
Okay.
Just a surprise ka pa ba yan, Richard?
Let's go to your
let's do
play.
Enjoy most, ha?
Right. Of course, Rica Rambulo.
Kanina pang ano, eager na eager si Richard to test his voice.
Check lang na.
Wait, you chose these songs, right?
Did we? No, actually, a lot of them are in the soundtrack of our movie.
Ah, I thought they had there was a connection in your past.
We had the rise up at the wrong time. I guess I always knew inside I wouldn't have you for a long time. Those dreams of yours shining on different shores. When a bear calls,
I don't want to talk anymore, but we have to come back and have some intimate conversation with these two romantic people, like after this.
We'll be back. We had the right love at the wrong time, no?
Rica Arambulo. Thank you, Rica. She's going to warm things up for us. And I wish every night we could have something like this, no? A very intimate tête-à-tête.
Mm-hmm.
How's your feeling about being paired with Richard again?
Oh, nice. Wonderful. It was nice working with him again.
Yeah, after 6 years.
Yeah, it was fun.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Now, tonight, we're going to have something very different. Different from your show, different from what you've done before on TV, testing, different from your sitcom. We're going to have a...
Different from my past Julie show appearance.
Yeah. I'll make more people jealous tonight. Tonight, we're going to have a he said, she said, so that with our viewers participating, you can give them insights into the questions about love and relationships.
Wow.
Since this is supposed to be a very romantic movie, no? Ano ba yung title?
Minsan
Minahal
Kita. I can already see an unhappy ending kasi minsan parang past.
But you have to watch it. It's about two married people who have an affair.
Who are not married to each other. Okay, I'll watch. Now, we have our first caller, and I hope your answers will not be the same, no? From a male and a female perspective. Chiki. Our first caller is Francis.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Hello, yes. Good evening.
Hi, Francis.
Hello.
Makasawa mo yan, di kaya?
Hindi niya kabos. Hindi niya kabos. Hi, Francis.
Hello.
Yeah. Go ahead.
May wife po ako. 5 years na po kami. Nagsususpecha po ako na meron po siyang ibang minimit na guy. gusto ko po sanang maki-discuss namin to. Kaso medyo nahihiya po ako kasi nung nag-work po ako sa abroad. Ako din po kasi may na-meet din po ako na girl doon. At I fear na baka ma-bring up yung girl na yon. Wala po siyang, hindi po niya alam yung affair na yon na nangyari sa akin dun sa abroad.
So what's your problem, Francis?
Hindi ko po kasi alam kung ano po yung gagawin ko. Kasi nagsususpect po ako na meron po siyang minimit na guy.
Okay. You want me to answer first?
Sure.
I don't know.
First, do you think he has a problem?
I think he's got a big problem. He's got a big problem.
That's for certain.
The thing is, are you ready to take the consequences? Pag inamin ng babae sa'yo na meron nga siyang kalaguyo.
Oh, ba't sa akin ka nakatingin?
Hindi. Kasi tatlo lang tayo dito eh.
Parang galit ka sa akin. Wala naman akong ginagawa.
Are you ready to take the consequences? Pag sinabi niyang, oh, kasi meron akong nakikita minimit na lalaki. And I want to end this relationship. Doon ako sa lalaki. Are you ready to take that?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you just want to work on it and pretend that you don't know anything?
I think what Francis wants is for the two of you especially to condone what he's doing.
No, but what I think the best really is for the two of them to talk it over, to talk it out.
Mm, he only suspects so far.
Yeah, mahirap kasi when you suspect eh.
But like you said, is he willing to take the consequence of his wife admitting that she's unfaithful?
Not only because he also had something with someone else.
In the past, no?
Yeah, abroad. So what does that mean? Francis, you're calling and asking because you want to save your marriage?
Yes, ma'am.
You want to save your marriage? Where's the other girl?
Nandun pa rin po.
Nasa
abroad pa rin po.
Kayo pa rin?
Abroad pa rin po. Hindi na po.
Ay, hindi na.
Natatakot lang po ako na i-bring out yung past, yung nangyari po nung...
If you're not together, then I guess it's a lot easier to talk about it.
Yeah.
But if you still live in one roof, then it's a different thing. Don't you think so?
Tanungin mo na lang siya diretso, Francis, na maganda. Sabi mo lang, minababalitaan ka. Give her a chance to talk.
Pero mag-asawa pa rin ba kayo?
Yes.
Mag-asawa pa rin kayo?
That's the problem. He's married.
But you live in different countries. Yeah.
No. He thinks his wife is having an affair with somebody here. Mm-hmm. But his past is burdened by the fact that he had an affair with a girl abroad. But that should not be the problem anymore. Kasi tapos na, no?
Put it behind you. If she doesn't know, you know, take care of her feelings. Don't na lang tell her.
The best is to talk it over.
Yeah, just talk it over. Sabi mo yung
pinagdududahan. Give her a chance to deny. I think Francis should give his wife a chance to deny it.
Right, and if she, let's say she admits it for any reason.
Should she admit it? That's another question
for another show. But Francis, if she admits it, kaya mo ba?
Isa nga po yun yung sa fear ko. I don't know how I would take it.
I think that will depend on how much you want to save the marriage. Diba? Kung gusto mo talaga yung marriage and she's remorseful, forgive her na lang and move on. Pag umamin. Pag hindi, di pretend na lang wala kang narinig.
So, ang gusto, ano?
Wala naman perfect eh.
Ma'am, sa tingin niyo po ba, ano po ba yung mga reasons kung bakit nagagawa yun ng mga asawang babae? Kasi hindi...
Kasi ginagawa
niyo
eh.
Yung ginagawa mo, anong reasons mo? Oh. Minsan lonely ka lang. Siguro na nag-abroad siya, feeling niya, dinededma mo siya.
Diba? I'm not defending the male society, ah. Pero more often than not, ganoon talaga nangyayari pag yung mga lalaki, especially in a group, pag lumalabas sila, you know, parang to guys, it's just fun.
But hello?
I'm not justifying the kalokohan.
Yeah, there's no, just, hello.
I'm just telling you the truth. You know, this is what really happens.
It's
a totally different story.
You
can say that, but it's a totally different story. Pag yung babae na ang naglolokoh.
Bakit? Can you tell me why?
I guess it's Filipino culture.
So when a guy fools around,
it's okay.
I didn't say it was okay.
Yeah, but you said it's permitted.
I'm saying this is reality.
No, you're saying...
Well, see, you're not saying it's okay, but it's reality.
I'm showing you the future.
I'm showing you the picture.
Mm-mm.
But I did not agree to that picture.
No, but you're saying that it's more an okay for the wife to do that. It's less okay for the woman.
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know.
Because women are more precious. On that I agree with Richard. Women are more precious, so we should value them and cherish their purity even more.
Right.
Okay, next call. Thank you very much, Francis.
Thanks, Francis.
All right, when we come back, we'll ask our guidance counselors about romance in the workplace. Is it healthy? Does it inspire the lovers? Or does it make them perspire when we come back? Wanting to interrupt, ano, parang give na give si Richard.
Hindi, I enjoy singing. But people don't enjoy listening to me. That's a problem, eh.
Well, maybe...
But given the chance, I will not stop.
But you've never appeared in a musical movie yet?
Not yet. Oh,
okay.
Maybe now, in the future, who knows?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Miss Saigon.
Miss Saigon.
Miss Arab. Yes. Things like that. You can always dream.
Why is Sharon behaving like that?
Huh?
Why Sharon behaving like that?
That's really the thing. National TV.
Okay, back to our question about the workplace. So, what are your opinions about romance in the workplace?
It's scary. If you can avoid it, then do so by all means. But sometimes you never know if your true love is going to be calling from the workplace. So,
But that has happened to you, falling in love with your leading man on the set?
Well, it's a different kind of workplace. Eh? It's not like an
fantasy,
office setup.
No? It's a fantasy world. No?
Usually you're thrown into each other's company for most of the day and for a long period of time.
And you're at your best.
Yeah.
And you're emoting so intensely.
Right.
So,
not only that, you get to kiss that person too.
Yeah. And if he or she is a good kisser, the battle is half won.
Almost. But in an office, I think it's very dangerous. No?
Why?
Doesn't it inspire the two people? Everybody.
Why should they know about it?
Huh?
Why should they know about it?
At first, hindi lang malaman, pero the time will come, tataka sila. But ang tagal ng secretary sa office ng boss? What does it take the secretary 1 hour to get out of the room?
You mean they have to do it right there in the office?
No. What?
Ah, no.
It is a serious issue.
Make people suspicious. Yeah. Huh?